Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Stash and Beard Show. I'm Austin Postolka. This is Alan Pilley.
What's up, motherfuckers?
And we are fucking ready to go spraying
double finger points.
Double finger points all the way.
With the hammers. Bottom triggers. Side.
Anything else you want to add?
Load up the meat cannon.
Oh, no, no, we're not. Meat cannons.
What the fuck kind of gun do you have?
You said to have a trigger, so I put a trigger on it. I'm like, ah.
You wouldn't think like, you know, the
well, it's gotta be,
foreplay finger?
It's gotta, it's gotta be far away from the barrel or like, Spider-Man.
Yeah, there we go. There we go. Fuck trigger fingers. Spider webs. Good morning, y'all. What the fuck is up?
Hey, welcome back to the Stash and Beard Show. Wow, holy cow. It's been quite a week. And meat cannons aside, I mean, I gotta tell you, it's been an incredible week. It was Easter weekend. Well, yeah, totally. I mean, it was Easter weekend. I ate my weight in cheesy potatoes.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, man. I'm not gonna be able to recover from the cheesy potatoes for
like
2 or 3 days.
I'm good on cheesy potatoes.
Are you not a cheesy potato guy?
No. Straight up, like, high blood pressure, salt all in them type of southern mashed potatoes. But keep the cheese out.
Keep the cheese out?
Yeah, keep the cheese out, in my opinion. But hey, you like them, brother?
I do.
Go
like
for them.
Dig
them.
Here's the thing.
Eat them.
I will. Over and over and over again. The thing, though, is that Liz is lactose intolerant, so cheese is not in our day-to-day diet.
Yeah.
Because she goes grocery shopping, and I don't care enough to, like, throw cheese in everything. The only thing I have is cottage cheese, because that's, like, quick snack, quick protein, all that good
stuff.
Whatever. But, like, on the regular, we're not having, like, lasagna.
Yeah.
You know, we're not, that's not part of our diet. And so when I finally get the chance to go hard on something super cheesy,
yeah,
I take advantage.
Yeah, I'm one of them, like, throw salt on salt.
Yeah.
Like, I want salt in anything. Yeah. And my wife is not a salt fan. Like,
really?
Pepper on every fucking thing.
Yeah.
And I don't like pepper. So.
Really?
Nope, not a pepper fan.
Man.
Yeah. But
that's
you put salt on a salt lick.
And you're like, yes.
Yep, and now I'm at home.
Is,
and then fucking throw some blood pressure into the pot.
Yeah.
Mix up with potato. That's. And butter. Now we're talking. So anyway.
But did you have a good weekend with festivities
or
anything?
I don't get into all that Easter crap.
Sure.
You know, the way like the Catholic Church will and things like that. But this is more about the kids.
Yeah.
So getting to watch them, you know, Easter baskets and egg hunts and things like that. That's what I'm about. So that was a good time.
I got to try out a VR headset for the first time.
So this 3D stuff that's now that you can add onto your phones.
No, like an actual home Oculus set that my aunt and uncle or my nephew bought himself.
Okay.
Nephew, cousin. He bought himself, and he was like, stand right here, put the headset on me, handed me my hands because you can see your hands in the thing with
neat.
And I'm just looking around. I'm just in the home screen, and there's like a ski lodge, and I'm like, where am I? How is this?
And you're moving.
And
so
I moved around
inside your living room and make sure everything's out of the way.
It was the craziest experience I've ever had, and it was so crazy that when I took it off, and I was like, okay, I know that I'm in the real world. I know that, and I went to like pick something up. I'm like, okay,
really?
It messed with me. It messed with me.
So Royce's birthday is about to be up end of the month, and he's asked for a 3D kit that you plug into your phone, and play games and stuff. So.
Yeah.
The very first one I opened up on Amazon, $560. And I'm like, absolutely not.
Yikes.
But I don't know anything about this stuff. And, you know, this is also my son who's about to be 6.
Right. So it's not like.
Yeah. So I'm going to sit here and buy this kid something 3D-ish, you know. So I don't know. We're talking about it.
Yeah.
We'll
see.
But it's funny that you said you got to try that out because that was one of his asks over the weekend for his upcoming birthday.
Yeah. But with having a holiday weekend, for me, it meant not a lot of lifting took place. On Wednesday, we had bench press night, but I missed pulls on Sunday. Which pulls, what were y'all doing? It was so many
Buddy,
different bands.
Yeah, me and Buddy, it's been great getting to run ideas off each other because it keeps it fucking fun, but it also challenges us.
Yeah.
Like, we'll see some shit and be like, that we can beat them, or we'll see some shit and be like, it, we can do this.
Yeah.
So it was a West Side Conjugate post, about downward pulling bands and forward pulling. So the forward pulling is supposed to pull the bar away from you, and we keep lat engagement.
Sure.
So I sent it over to Buddy or vice versa, and we're like, fuck yeah. And I'm like, I knew he'd like it. Nine times out of ten, he's on par with some crazy fucking shit.
Right.
And so we did that, and the idea was to pull against the band and then up against the band.
Okay.
And to just make it fucking stupid crazy.
It looks stupid crazy.
Yeah.
I'm so sad that I missed it.
You got about 200 band pulling down against whatever weight you throw on the bar. Mm-hmm. And we don't. Who knows? Tension.
Yeah.
Pulling back forward. Just enough to get lat engagement. Nothing where the bar slingshots.
We're not over
yeah,
here.
Exactly.
Like,
you're not trying to do a fucking barbell roll in or something like that. But we get to do it tonight. So yeah. Looking forward to what we get to pull.
Yeah, for sure. And so it was a big weekend also for competitions.
Yeah. We were scattered across the nation.
Yeah.
Yet again. So it was pretty neat.
And a couple winners.
Yes. So we had Ray down in Miami for Miami's Baddest Man.
Yep.
This is the fifth year of the show. It was supposed to be number six, but COVID decided to kick it in the nuts last year.
Yeah.
So, De La Pava threw it this year, and Ray on 4 weeks' notice got ready to go do the show.
Yeah, it was out of nowhere for him.
He was really what it was supposed to be was a tune-up to get him ready for Florida's Strongest Man, mm-hmm. Which is another huge show up here by Alan Colley. But anyway, Michael had Miami's Baddest for, like I said, the last 5/6 years. Me and Ray did it 3 years ago, and he ended up beating me. And that was like his first intro into the sport.
Uh-huh.
So since then, he's
Strongman.
Into Strongman.
Yeah.
Yep. And he's since done other Strongman shows and things, and he had 4 weeks to do this one as a tune-up. Mm. Went down there and took the title.
Yeah. What were the events this time?
So he started out with max deadlift. You had 3 attempts to reach up to the heaviest deadlift. So it was kind of sort of like powerlifting rules.
Yeah.
And
it was
neat.
Just regular deadlift.
Deadlift.
It wasn't like axle.
Nope.
It wasn't
straight bar deadlift.
Really?
Deadlift bar, and you can strongman it, which means you get the hitch. You can use straps. You just can't sumo.
Gotcha.
Ray was the only one to walk out there strap free. Like, and they kept making comments that, you know, oh, no straps, no straps. And he went up there and pulled an easy 705
nice.
For a second place victory in that. Then he took first place in the log press axle press medley.
He's a great overhead presser.
So that's what I was getting at. So 3 years ago, maybe four, to get him into the sport, he was just going to train with me. He didn't want to do anything with it. Mm-hmm. And originally, when me and him had met each other, was him hitting me up saying, hey, I want to come to CTX for strongman.
Yeah.
He came over. We didn't really do strongman. He did more powerlifting. Mm-hmm. And then Miami's Baddest showed up 4 years ago, 3 years ago, and I got him to do that. And he ended up going down there and beating me.
Yeah.
So it's like a huge joke, you know, like I didn't even want to fucking do this. I go out there and I beat you. And I was like, well, yeah, like, but he's that good at the sport. You know what I'm saying? And
He was a D1 football player.
Yep, like, for UCF.
When it comes to moving and strength
and
he,
athletics
he's,
and
he's
things.
Got it.
Yeah. So, you know, it was just a natural carryover, in my opinion. Mm. So, you know, the log press, the axle press, he did that one. He took first in that. And then we moved into a sandbag carry, sandbag toss, and there's some strategy here.
Okay.
So what he had to do was whoever carried the bag the farthest meant nothing if you didn't get a bag over the 15-foot wall. So you could have just carried the bag 10 feet and gotten a bag, but then that means that I go and carry it for 11 and get a bag over the wall and I win.
Right.
So what you want to kind of do is maybe push me a little bit, maybe go 200 feet.
Mm-hmm.
But as you're going 200 feet, or you have enough hamstring left to get a bag over.
Right.
So you may have done that. Now I got to push. I got to go get 201 feet, but still go get a bag. So
and it's
there's
not
some strategy.
And it wasn't like a toss the bag, go pick it back up, run it.
You
it
had
wasn't
three
time.
Attempts.
Okay.
So you had to carry the bag. I had to push you. I had to think, man, is Austin a good bag carrier?
Yeah.
So I'm going to go and like, yeah, he is. I remember from past events. So I'm going to carry 200 feet.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got to get a bag over, but I only have 3 attempts. So if by the third attempt, I don't get a bag, this 200-foot carry means dick.
Right.
So I push you 200 feet. I get a bag. Boom. Austin's up. Yeah. You now have to go get 201. You can't get 150 in a bag.
Right.
You got to get 201 and a bag. So
wow. Okay.
Ray was last on that one going into it. So he knew what he had to do to beat the dude ahead of him.
Nice.
Got an extra 3 feet. Dropped the bag, or dropped the keg, actually, and then threw the sandbag over.
Yeah.
And then the very last event he took first in was the stone over bar. Mm-hmm. Guy went up ahead of him, took 4 reps. Ray knew he needed 5 and got 5.
What was the weight on the...
330-pound stone. So a 330-pound stone for reps, a 300-pound keg for carry, and then a 50-foot bag over wall. 275 axle, 275 log. He had to get reps.
He's got
to
be feeling it today.
Yeah. And then he pulled 705 on the third attempt. And then going working backwards now. I'm out of an event. I can't remember. Oh, and then he had a 900-pound yoke run, 25 feet down, turn, 330-pound per hand farmers, back
Whoa.
Down, 25 feet.
No joke for these weights.
No, he moved everything. It was a good weekend for him.
Good.
So awesome. He took home the trophy, which is an actual axe.
Yeah, his posts are so funny. He's got an axe with his fork, you know, mm-hmm. for his scrambled eggs, you know, he put up a video of him with other of Miami's baddest gangsters. Funny stuff, man.
No, it was a good weekend.
There were some other people up in Syracuse.
Yep, we were up in Syracuse this weekend as well. We had Maura and Julian.
Yeah.
They were at powerlifting meet up there at Rita West's Blood Iron Barbell meet.
And Maura, like, it was out of the blue as well.
Out of the blue. She texted me up on the Thursday, and she's like, I got a serious question to ask. Mm. And I'm like, what's up? And she's like, this meet has 10 lifters. It could have 11.
It
double question mark.
It could.
And I'm laughing because I've been trying to get her back from some injuries, some little nagging stuff.
Sure.
And I'm like, well, how do you feel? And she just sends me back a bag of money emoji.
Yeah.
And I'm like, fuck it, let's do it.
Hell yeah.
So she got signed up. And now we get to put her on the board officially. She put a 500 squat in the books.
Nice.
Put a 235 bench up in the books and pulled 385.
There you go.
So her 1120 total.
Yeah.
Yep. Which is her first geared total.
Nice.
Weighing in, I think she weighed in at a buck 60 something.
Mm-hmm.
So that was pretty epic.
Yeah.
And then we had Julian. Julian was our raw with wraps. Mm-hmm. He put up a 740 squat, 435 bench, and pulled 635.
Goodness.
For an 1820 total. I think 1820.
Yeah.
And took best lifter from the meet.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Hell
but he's
yeah.
one of these, you know, he calls me up, and, you know, he's, you know, we're talking, and I'm like, hey, dude, you know, I was there because I didn't hear much from him and then, you know, all day long. And Ray was coming up to me in between events, and I'm like, hey, I think Julian bombed. Like, he's just not answering nothing. And Moore's over here firing. She's like, hey, boss, this, hey, boss, that. And I'm like, hey, that's awesome, Julian. And nothing, I don't hear nothing. So Ray kept coming up, checking on him, and I'm like, dude, I think he bombed. Like, I'm not hearing nothing. So at the end of the day, I said, hey, dude, like, you good? Because I know how it feels to bomb. It f***ing sucks, man.
Yeah.
So he's like, you know, I made it through the meet. Not what I wanted. But, and he sends me a photo. Best lifter. And I get up from my chair. Like,
fuck
Ray's
you.
About to go inside. I get up from my chair. I'm like, call him on WhatsApp. I'm like, are you f***ing kidding me? Are you serious? You don't answer me all f***ing day long and you give me this? And he starts laughing. But this is Julian for you. So he's like, yeah. He's like, you know, but it's just like, it was just 10 lifters, though. And I was like, dude. Who gives a fuck? Today you outlifted the 10 that showed up. You did better than them,
yeah.
right? You know what I mean? Like on today, you showed up and did better than them. You know,
absolutely.
So then all of a sudden you see his attitude change. Like, yeah, he's like, you're right. And I'm like,
what was he? Hold on. What were his goals?
So
going into it,
he had wanted 2,000 pounds. And
okay.
Everything's lined up that it was going to happen.
Sure.
But a depth issue on his first two. So he was about to bomb out of the meet. And that's when I checked in with him on squats and I never heard from him. And I'm like, fuck, man, I'm going to let him be.
Yeah.
Didn't hear nothing. I was like, so it didn't get time until Maura texts me when I hit him up and I'm like, yeah, I think he's
right.
I think he's had enough time. Let me ask him, hey, dude, you all right?
Yeah.
And then he hits me with that. You know? So 1820 on a shitty day, you know, like, motherfucker, take that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
And the strength issues, you know, these are technical errors. You know, these are things, you know, I can't, you know, you want to go into the bench press and you want to beat the pause call, or I mean the press call. It's not a strength issue.
Right.
You know, that's a you issue. You know what I'm saying? Like learn your commands, stay in the game, things like that. Depth, you know, the thing about depth, you know, we got some of these Instagram people, you know, they'll be like, they'll high ass squat all fucking prep.
Yeah.
All prep, 8, 12 weeks, high squats. But every time they write, it's okay, high-ass squats. It'll be there on meet day.
It'll be there on meet day.
It'll
I'll
be there on meet
the
day.
I'll flip the switch and I'll go.
Exactly. You know, like, oh, it'll
Bullshit.
Be there for me. And Julian's the exact opposite. Julian, he'll sink these motherfuckers in training.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about, like, ball bag on ground,
yeah.
you know, and then we go to the meet and it's like he gets in his head. So that's, you know, what I've been working on with him is more that mental strength game, you know, type of thing. Like, hey, the people in front of you don't fucking matter, dude.
Right.
You know, and I hit him up on a text and I said, hey, this is after a second squat. And I wrote him up and I said, dude, it's Sunday. You're back in Florida. You're squatting with your boys.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Bar's loaded. You're hanging out with us.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we're just having a good time. And I sent that to him and then didn't hear nothing.
Right, of course.
But the funny thing is, afterwards, he's like, dude, I read that text. And that's what I ran with the rest of the day. And I'm like, you motherfucker. Like,
let me know.
Me sit here, think the whole day you bombed out type of thing. So, but yeah, so amazing weekend for three of our athletes. So it was a good time.
Good.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's
yeah, real so good cool. time.
Love to hear that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And apparently, lifting for the two of us.
Yeah, you know, we'll see after tonight.
Yeah.
We'll see after tonight. The neat thing about seeing you guys lift on Sunday and then coming in on Monday is I know what I have to beat. The horrible thing about y'all lifting on Sunday is I see what I have to beat.
Yeah.
So it's like, Jesus, man, like I gotta go do that. So yeah. it should be a good time tonight. We'll see.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And then I did some more, I mean, obviously I do TikToks, but I recorded a couple good lifting TikToks that I'm pretty proud of.
Yeah.
Yeah, like there are a lot of trends on TikTok with different sounds and whatnot, and our goal is always to try and get those viral sounds and to immediately put something out there that is funny and also lifting.
I'm not a TikToker, so what sound? What do you mean?
So there's a big one going around right now that is a country music song. I don't need this menu. No, I don't.
Never heard of
this. I already know just what I want. So, the joke is when I pull up to a Waffle House, like the one that's gone viral is, I pull up to a Waffle House. Oh,
is this
dear,
the one
you,
from yesterday? Or yeah. From, okay, Saturday?
Yes. You know, do you need, ma'am, do you need a, or do you need a menu? I don't need this menu. No, I don't. And you just lip sync to the song. So I put up a daily wad,
uh-huh.
And
went, okay.
I don't need this menu, and then I hugged the bench press.
I gotcha. Okay. So funny, because we came in here yesterday, and uh-huh. Somebody was erasing it. They're like, God, what was this? And the only person I know in here that does wads is Liz.
Right.
And it said 7 rounds for time. And I went back last night, you know, to program her, and I'm like, there was no 7 rounds for time. Like, what did you do to yourself? Like, and you know, and yeah. You're the husband, so you can vouch for this.
Yep.
Liz may have seen 7 rounds for time.
She could have.
And so absolutely. I'm legit, I'm looking at him like, God, like, and what the last workout was for last week. I'm just looking at him, I was like, yo, you did 7 rounds of this shit? Like, what the fuck, man?
That's terrible. Yeah, exactly. Why would you do that?
Yeah.
Because so, she's done that.
Yeah,
in
yeah,
the
yeah. No, 100%. Absolutely. That's why I was like, oh, I didn't say shit. I was like, oh, that was Liz. She writes her shit up on the board.
Right.
Not knowing that was you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's pretty funny.
So we've got a couple other ones coming out where I'm pretty excited for. You can follow at Actually Average on TikTok to see those. Yeah, we've got more topics to hit later on in the show, the Stash and Beard show. We'll be back after this.